Hey guys, my name's Nate, and I'm the Otter Outdoorsman, and today, we're going to be talking about hats. Multiple different types of hats. Hats that you can wear in all seasons. And hats that you wear outdoors. Now why do I want to talk about hats? It's because I like them. Let's get started. Sorry about that, I just kind of want to play around with editing. But anyways, in all seriousness, today's video, I want to talk about hats and the different types you can basically wear outside, and go over the different types that I do wear. Primarily, I tend to wear three or four different types of hats. Generally, I wear ones that have a front brim. Well, there really are three different types, so to speak, but there are hundreds of types of hats. But when it comes to me in hats, there's ones with a brim on the front, a fully surrounded brim, basically a brim that goes completely around the hat, and one with no brim at all. That's a general statement. Yes, there are ones that have three-quarters brim. There's a lot of different types, but generally when it comes to me, those are the types that I wear. Now, I tend to wear, on my day-to-day, I tend to wear a scally cap. I do sometimes wear these outside. 90% of the time, if you run into me, this is actually the hat you will see me wearing. It's a wool scally cap that, during the winter, keeps my head warm and keeps the sun out of my eyes. Now, what is the advantage of wearing a hat when you're out in the woods? Well, a lot of things. For one, if it's sunny out, you can tend to tuck it down and actually can help shade your eyes from the sun. A couple other things that helps insulate your head. It can keep the rain off your head. Keeps the rain out of your eyes. A lot of different uses. Now, every different hat kind of has different properties, different uses. And the thing is, some of the ones that are more insulative aren't really great for the summer, which is why I've started developing more of a collection for hats, because me personally, when I leave the house, and sometimes even when I shoot videos, I don't not wear a hat. So I've kind of started collecting more and more hats. I'm kind of looking for a wicking scally cap. I'm struggling to find a good one. One made of a wicking material. So if anyone actually sees one like this, and they know of one that's made of a wicking material, please tell me. Seriously. But anyways, so the reason I like scally caps like this also is because these tend to not get kicked up by the wind a lot. On windy days, sometimes the problem I have with baseball caps is when the wind hits it, it actually knocks it up, but because of how it's designed, actually sometimes it helps push it down, especially when I kind of tuck my head down a little bit, actually kind of keeps it down. So scally caps I find really nice, and especially the type I have with wool, it doesn't hold on to smells as long. But the problem is, I don't bring this one a lot out with me when I go camping. I sometimes do. I tend to take it out with me hiking, but not with me camping because I don't like it smelling like smoke as much. But it doesn't hold on to the smell as much, but the inside is made out of cotton, so sometimes it does. So I've been thinking about buying a few other ones. The problem is, I haven't sourced this specific pattern online because I bought this at a Scottish Highland Games in New Hampshire. So I haven't found it online. This one specifically is made by Epoch. But anyways, so let's move on to the next type of hats. So baseball caps and trucker hats are also really nice, or trucker style hats. Baseball caps with the full, basically the full coverage, and the trucker style hats that basically have mesh in the back but still have a little bit of coverage in front and have that bill in the front. These are really nice because they still give you a bit of coverage from the sun, like the scally caps do. But the brim really does help when you're trying to block away from the sun. My issue I've had with ones like the trucker hats is when it comes to precipitation, they don't block as much from rain with the trucker hats. Baseball caps, you can get a little bit more protection from the rain, but not as much as like with my wool scally that I get. But that's because this one's made of wool. Thinner ones will be more like this. Will be in the same issue that I would run into with a baseball cap. These don't really have as much protection from precipitation, but they do really help against the sun, at least for your eyes. They do help shield your eyes, not so much as not so much any part of your face, like your ears or the back of your neck, unless you put it on backwards. With me, a lot of times with baseball caps, I sometimes do like wearing them out every once in a while. I wear them out much more than I wear a trucker's hat out. The benefit of something like a trucker's cap, though, is you get much more breeze that goes through these. You get a lot more air circulation. So on a hot day, a hat like this, the mesh that goes through the back, I found I get a lot more air circulation going through these. And so when that breeze comes through and my head is sweaty on a hot summer's day, This really comes through. The other benefit of hats like these over a thicker cap like this, though, is on a rainy day, I can use my hood and still wear these. I can grab my hood, throw it over. I still can protect if the sun comes out, or I still protect my eyes from the rain with a hat like this. But at the same time, my hood goes straight over it, and I'm fine. One of the other hats I've been wearing, I forgot the name of the style of hat. But it's basically this hat. I bought it on sale from, I think, Sports Authority when they were going out of sale. I mean, when they were going out of business. I scooped in, and whenever I go to a store, I always check out their hat sales. I go to their hat section, always see if I find a cool new hat that I like. I found this little cap. And this one's really, I really like this one. You see it in some of my summer videos when I go out. This one's really nice. It's made out of polyester. And one of the really nice things about this is this wicks away sweat. It's disgusting how much you can see it in the brim. This really helps to wick away the sweat, and it brings it into here, and just kind of similar to how the trucker's hat does it, whereas this one gives you nice circulation. Having a hat like this, when I don't have as much hair and I kind of trim it back a little bit, this helps for a little more convective cooling during the summer. Also, same thing with the brim. One thing I like about this one particularly is this one actually has a folding brim, so actually when I don't want to use it, I can fold it, put it in my pocket, put it in my pack, whatever. This one's actually designed for hiking more. But having a nice thin cap like this, as opposed to having a thicker cap like this baseball cap, which is a bit more thick. It's not super thick like my scally that I have, but it's thinner, but it's still on the thicker side. Having a thin cap like this does help keep the sun off my head, but at the same time it gives me a brim to keep the sun off my eyes and does give me a little bit of protection from the sun, but unfortunately not as much as the other two. Brings me to one of the other ones with a brim, which is the wide brim fedora. A lot of people also call this the Indiana Jones style hat. You can also get a, I forgot the name of it, but it's like those bucket hats. I'll put a picture of up of them. I don't actually have one. I'm still looking for a good one for myself. I just haven't found a style of one that I personally like myself, but I have been looking for one for myself. But effectively, the wide-brimmed fedora. These ones specifically, it's made out, it's knit wool. Not knit wool, it's felted wool. That's the term I'm looking for. I used to wear these a lot. When I went to school, when I went to college, I used to wear these a lot on bad weather days. And then when I used to go out a lot, I used to wear these. They're really good outdoor hats. I used to wear the, if you check a lot of my older videos, you'd see me wearing this hat a lot. Now, there is a reason I stopped wearing these as much. There's a few reasons. For one, when it comes to visibility, it's a little bit harder if I need to be looking up. This hat kind of gets in the way. And it's not like with a baseball cap, where if I'm doing bird watching, and I need to be able to look a little further up with my eyes, I can, with bird watching, I literally can just do this, and I have a bit more view. However, with this, I couldn't really do that. I have to take it down, plop it down, continue from there. The benefit of these is it's a full brim. With it, you have the benefit of your eyes are protected, your ears are protected, your neck gets a bit of protection. The problem is also size. I also didn't like it because it was a little bit, I personally didn't like wearing it out in public a lot. Some people do, but for style-wise, I also like having some of my outdoor hats. I also like having a hat that I can wear out in public as well, that matches kind of my personal style as well, which is why I like having my scally caps, because for me, this is what you got most of the day. And I used to wear these out in public a lot, but I don't like doing it as much. But I do like wearing these outdoors, or I used to as much. Sometimes the other benefit is these may hold their form a lot better, and they fold down flat a lot better. The problem I have with these is sometimes as well, if you do fold them and they do stay in that form for long, they do hold that shape for longer. As much as I did like these, I also found they were a little bit too big and cumbersome. And don't get me wrong, I liked them, and I still do, I obviously do keep one around if I do want it. I use them more for when I need one, basically. But it kind of got to the point where it was a little bit too big for me. I needed something a little more streamlined. Because sometimes also when you're moving through the brush, sometimes this would catch a branch and it would cut off and I'd have to grab it again. And if you're wearing a tall pack, the problem was this would get caught on the back of the pack. So if you're carrying a tall pack, you'd lean back and it would pop out. So this one has its upsides and its downsides. Mostly just size, but I mean it's up to your preferences are your own. So I ended up going with something a little bit more streamlined. The other issue with it is also during the summer, even though it does keep the sun off your face, sometimes it can also be a little too insulative, and your head, if you're like me and you sometimes can deal with a little bit, you have trouble dealing with heat. It doesn't keep you as cool. You have to kind of take it a fan. And I had trouble having it basically keep me cool. I thought it would give me good shade, but it ended up, I didn't like wearing it in the summer as much. And so I didn't use it as much because it kind of warmed me up too much. But moving off of the summer, kind of moving more towards the winter, you also got to think about kind of caps. I tend to wear, in the winter when I go out, I like to wear knit caps. I sometimes, as I said, I like to wear this a lot during the winter, on my day to day. But when I go out in the woods, I often tend to wear a knit cap. This one I had a friend make for me. It's a little oversized. It's kind of how I like it. Basically, kind of covers my ears enough so that I can stay warm. It's thick, 100% wool, and I love it. You don't need 100% wool. You could go with 80, but 100% wool, usually with the caps, but if it's a good quality wool, usually will keep you warm. The benefits of these is, for one, you can keep them in your pack. You can keep them stashed down, really small, pack them down. And the thing is, if it's during the summer and you don't expect it to get really, really cold, you can buy small ones. Like, I recently bought a pack from a company called Buff that also makes a kind of like a neck thing that also becomes a scarf and a bunch of other things. And they also gave me it comes with a cap, which I don't want to carry this out with me on a hiking trip, and I want to still have a cap, I have this. So if it's going to be cold, especially if I'm going up to New Hampshire, where sometimes even in the summer, I can still drop down in the 40s, and if I'm being a bit more weight conscious, I can still have that. I don't want to carry this with me, which I've had to make that sacrifice. I can still carry this with me, and it won't be as great, but it's enough that I can keep the insulation in just enough. It is a little bit warmer, but unfortunately it won't be as good as if I'm wearing this. You can take it as you will. The thing is, the downside of the knit caps is you have to be a little bit more careful with them. It's harder to wash them because depending on the wool, they do start to felt up. They get a little bit more wear and tear. Like, this one's already kind of fuzzing up after a few years of use. But I also kind of, I try and take my best to take care of it. But it's, you know, it's showing its age. But at the same time, I kind of like that it's showing its age. So the downside of definitely having a knit cap is it takes a bit more use, especially if it's handmade. It takes a bit more care to it. You can buy ones that are made out of fabric. Those ones sometimes won't always be as insulative. Sometimes they will. And the benefit of those is those take a little less care, and those ones can be cleaned a lot easier. And those don't take as much, those ones don't have as much cleaning instructions to them. And they also can sometimes be packed down as nicely. This one, personally, I haven't given as much tests to. This one's relatively new to me. Because it hasn't been the warmer seasons yet, but I do look forward to trying this one out. But anyways, so yeah, those have been kind of just some of my hats. If I was to go into more detail about hats and show off a lot more, this video could literally be hours and not just 20, 25 minutes. Honestly, when it comes to picking which hat you want to wear, find one that fits you. Seriously, find one that fits you, find one that meets your requirements, and just experiment. It's going to take you some experimenting until you find the hat that you want to use. Take it out, try it out. If you don't like it, give it to a friend. Keep it on hand, because you never know when you may want to use that hat again. Because sometimes, like, a hat like this may be great for a hike. A hat like this is actually really good for kayaking, or really good for, like, being out on the water, or out in the field, because I don't have as much coverage as I do in the woods. But a hat like this, or a baseball cap, I can move through the woods a lot better with, and I still get the protection from the sun. So, in my opinion, having different types of hats really do make my versatility a lot better. But anyways, my name's Nate. I'm the Otter Outdoorsman. There's been a lot of different hats that I've used. And you have a good day. Remember, get in the woods and have some fun. See everyone.